Good morning, everyone. Have no idea what day Vlogmas it is. From this day on, I will just not know. Hope you guys are having a great morning. Although, I guess the weekday vlogs are going out at night, so I hope you guys had a great day. This morning, I'm going to be doing something really glamorous. I'm going to be doing my laundry. Let me show you guys. I have a large pile of laundry to do right there. And for today, I have an interview dinner to go to later tonight, and then my friend Dania is also coming over to stay for her interview dinner and her interview tomorrow. So I also have an interview tomorrow and the day after, so you guys can stay tuned for that. And yeah, I'm gonna get my laundry started. I made myself some lunch. I have some olive bread, and then I made a little avocado mash with like one whole avocado, some olive oil, and some salt and red peppers, and like literally a squeeze of like this much lemon. It's like a little hat that I cut off from here. So I'm gonna have myself some avocado toast for lunch.
Well, I just spent the last hour or so working on some of the pictures for the new merchandise, and I'm super, super excited for them and for you guys to try them out. So I want to show you guys some of the stuff again. I know last time when I talked about it, I was wearing this Keep On Striving t-shirt, and I didn't get to show you guys the sweatshirt. So this is what the sweatshirt looks like. It says Keep On Striving in a bigger font. The lettering for this sweatshirt, as well as this t-shirt, they're both embroidered, so they're super, super pretty. And even the font, they're custom made, so I worked with an illustrator to really custom make all of the font and the lettering and the style and everything. So I'm really proud of how it turned out, and I really like it, and I hope you guys enjoy it too when you guys get them, probably sometime in January when the orders come in. The other sweatshirt that's also on sale is this one. This is the gray sweatshirt. It's more of a, I guess, like a classic sweatshirt with like the V detail, and this actually has like embroidered patch that says Strive. It's really similar to the ones that I released last year, but slightly better quality because it's like a little thicker, and I feel like the embroidery really makes a big difference in terms of style and how it looks. So these are the three items that are launching. So I spent like the last hour or so, like I said, like kind of working on things and like taking pictures, and I did everything kind of amateur, so I took all my pictures on my phone. So I want to show you guys some of my favorite pictures.
I thought this would be a good time to also talk about some of the sizing, because the sizing is a little confusing. All right, so this is the picture of the t-shirt that I posted, and in this picture I'm wearing the t-shirt in large, and I want to let you guys know that the shirts do run a little small, so I do have broad shoulders. Usually if I want something to be super fitted to my shoulder, I'll wear something medium, but this shirt is large and it's like fitting almost perfectly at my shoulders, so I want to say they do run small. In this picture you can see the sweatshirt. I guess you can't really see the sizing, but basically the sweatshirt I'm wearing is large, and it's fitting almost exactly the same way as this current gray sweatshirt, which is a small. So I'm gonna say these run a little big, and all the white sweatshirt and the white t-shirts, they run small. So just keep that in mind when you guys are placing the order. Hi everyone, so it is now almost 7 o'clock. I'm gonna head out to my interview dinner. I'm gonna leave the key downstairs for Dania so she can get in after her dinner. I'm hoping to do a small interview with her. Some of you guys have been asking like an interview with like a post bacc. I know Dania did a post bacc, and she's sort of a non-traditional applicant for med schools, so hopefully we'll be able to do that tonight, so stay tuned for that. So I'm back from my interview dinner, and Dania is also back from her interview dinner.
Yay.
And we're gonna talk a little bit about her post-bacc experience. Actually, if you're new, this is Dania, my friend.
Hi guys.
She's wearing the brand new striped sweatshirt, as am I.
Hi Candy.
No merchandise for you. All right, so tell me briefly about like your major in college, and whether you consider medicine in college or before college, like when you were younger.
I thought about medicine when I was in high school. But I wasn't really sure if that was something I was going to commit to because it was such a long time. 4 years is a long time to commit to after an undergraduate. I was a psych major in college, which kind of led me to think about psychiatry. But I wasn't sure because there's lots of different paths you could take on. You can do a clinical psychology, like PhD, or you can do a psychiatry program. So I took the time off after college to kind of figure out what I wanted to do and decided I was more interested in psychiatry. And then I decided to go down the post bacc path because medicine was like the path to get to what I wanted to get to. Not necessarily that medicine was something that I've always wanted to do.
So you consider like either like a PhD or a psychiatry, and between those two options, you thought that you might want psychiatry better?
Yeah. And I think it's there. You get to like weigh the pros and cons of each. And I think doing psychiatry, I felt like I would have more options to kind of do the things I liked about clinical psychology and combine them with psychiatry. And that was just my personal opinion, like what I thought was best for me at the time. But yeah, led me to medicine.
Very cool.
And eventually not psychiatry.
At all. We'll talk about that in a little bit. All right, so tell me about your post-bacc process.
I did a lot of research. So there's lots of different forums online that will tell you like all these different things to do, different places to go to, how much money you should spend, and I kind of just like took everything with a grain of salt. I don't know, I didn't know anyone who did a post bacc at the time, so it was just kind of like me figuring it out on myself, by myself. And I kind of had to figure out what was most the most important things. And the most important things for post bacc, based on like all the research I had done, was essentially to go somewhere where you can get good grades.
That's important.
Yes, that's like the number one thing,
yeah.
Probably tied with go to a place where you're guaranteed to get a letter of like recommendation. So
right.
The department has to write you a letter for medical school. So you need to kind of go to somewhere where they're going to write it for you, because there's no point in going through these years of courses and everything and then someone saying, hey, we're not going to write you that letter that you need
right.
for your application. So those were the two major things. And then after that, I kind of just focused on cost, because medical school is expensive by itself, and you're doing more schooling. So to find somewhere that had a balance of like a good reputation, but also that was not too expensive, mixed with like having the letter of recommendation that I needed and me being able to get good grades at that place, those are like the major criteria I looked for when I was going to a program.
Okay.
And then I kind of just narrowed it down from there.
Had you taken some of the pre-med classes during your undergrad, you know, during while you were getting your degree, or was this everything like was brand new again?
So I never took anything. I took one semester of chemistry in undergrad. One of the things that you have to look at is there's two different types of paths. One is a career changer, which is what I am, which means you've pretty much never taken pre-med classes ever, the chem, bio, orgo, physics. And then the other is pretty much if you're trying to improve your grades that you already have.
Okay.
And so those are two different types of paths. And when you go to look at post-bacc programs, it'll tell you like there's two paths that we have at this program. And which are you? So I had never taken it. So I was one of what they call like a career changer.
Okay. What were some challenges and some benefits of pursuing medicine via this non-traditional route?
I think benefits as far as when you're applying, you have a lot more life experience. You've kind of like taken the time to figure out what you want to do with your life. Maybe you've worked some other places, and just the benefit of even considering other options in your career is, I think, will help you in the long run, because you've kind of done research on everything else that kind of goes into those other paths.
Right.
And so when you get to medicine, you're really like, I'm doing medicine, like this is what I want to do. Some of the cons, I feel like it's not really till you get to medical school, you kind of feel like, okay, I've been out of this game a long time, and these people have been, you know, diehard medicine since like age two,
right.
Like their whole family's in medicine. And sometimes I feel like that can be like a little overwhelming, but that's something you get over like within the first year. It's just kind of like an adjustment process to realize, okay, I did all the same courses these people did, and you know, like we're on even playing field now.
You already mentioned like what to look for in a program. So any last parting advice for people who are considering medicine as a non-traditional applicant?
Last advice is really just to go to some place where you feel like they are making the program for people to succeed, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Like, a lot of places can just say, you know, we offer courses,
mm-hmm.
But they're not necessarily made up for their applicants to, like, succeed.
Mm-hmm.
Some of, I'm not saying they're, like, a money business, but
yeah.
You want to go somewhere where you're going to feel supported, you're going to feel like the staff is going to have your back, and, like, they really want their students to get to medical school.
Mm-hmm.
So when you go and you're looking at places, you know, figure out, like, where do people go afterwards, you know?
Mm-hmm.
If they say they're guaranteeing interviews at their school or they're guaranteeing acceptances based on GPA, like,
yeah,
try and talk to some of the people who are there because, you know, not everything is what it seems.
Right.
I think just talking to people who are in the programs or reaching out and kind of doing a little bit of research about the reputation of the programs will go a long way because you'll find some place that will fit you best. And honestly, the most important thing at the end of the day is to get the letter and to get good grades. It doesn't really matter where you go.
That's true.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's what the med schools look at in your application, your grades, your letter.
Mm-hmm.
The name of the school that you went to for post bacc really doesn't play a role, I feel like.
It's so minimal.
Yeah.
So minimal.
Right.
I would just say save your money for medical school because that's like a whole other investment.
That's true. Well, thank you for answering all the questions.
No problem.
Well, I'll let you get some rest for the interview tomorrow.
Thanks, you too.
All right. So this concludes the interview.
Bye, guys.
Bye. Hope you guys enjoyed the vlog. Hope you guys enjoyed the interview. If you have any questions about post bacc, leave it down below in the comments. And I will see you guys tomorrow. Bye. Pa, Kendi. Good cat.